I'll do it every minute of every day if that's what it takes to see somebody saved. Because God's given me a new life. For 4 years, I've been a different man in Jesus Christ. I'm filled with the power of the Holy Spirit now. Amen. I'm not the man I was. I'm a new creation. I'm a new man. And that's what anybody can have in here tonight. I'm a very quiet man outside of this church. But when I get behind here, I just want to tell you about the love of Jesus and what he's done for me. Because I was stuck in a dead religion. A religion I still respect with all my heart. The religion of my family. And that was a Catholic religion. But I came out of that religion because I wasn't able to lift my hands and pray that my Lord, Savior, and Redeemer, Jesus Christ. I couldn't do that. And if you're in here tonight and you can't lift your hands like that and praise Jesus, then don't call yourself a Christian of any kind, because it's just not the truth. You want to praise his name when you know that he died on that cross and saved you. I was really involved in the Catholic Church, people. Very, very much involved in the Catholic Church. I was on the parish council down in Langley, the big church, sister church to this one. I used to pray in this church with my own mother when it was St. Stephen's Church. But I was stuck in a seat doing exactly where the devil, a true enemy, that's where he wanted me to be, where I could do nothing, particularly nothing for my own people, the traveling people. So I married a Christian girl 30 years ago, and I went to meetings and conventions and that, and I loved having the crack with the boys around, in and around the born-again church. But to be honest with you, the truth be told, I thought I was in a proper religion with a proper man with a shirt like this one with a white collar, and that was the way to go. But I didn't have a relationship with the true living Christ. That relationship that gives you, that me, an old man, gives me the energy you see. It's like I'm on drugs because I've got Jesus inside of me now. That's how I've got a true relationship with him. And you can have that as well. Because see, when I was in that Catholic church, the thing of it was, I could sit amongst them people. There were no other traveling people in there. You get the odd one coming now and again. But I could sit there and I looked like an angel to them because they didn't know what I was doing in the world. The difference in this church, we're in amongst our own for the most part. We respect every nation of this world, but most of us in here are travelling people, one kind or another. And when you come into this church, everybody can see what you're doing. The thing of it is, the trick of the devil, and the trick the devil had for me was that only perfect people could get to heaven. And it's not the truth. It's by his grace and his precious blood that anybody could be saved in here tonight. My religion told me that I had to work towards that, to be a good person. And I think I was a good person, but I would never ever be good enough to meet the standards of God. God the Creator, the perfect standard. What travelling man, what travelling woman could ever reach that? So that was the trap I was in. Now I'm free, I'm happier than I've ever been in my life. I was 49 years old when I got saved, and that was the day in June, then 4 years ago, back in Staines in some big old tent, my life started. I tell you, if you don't know Jesus Christ in here tonight as your Lord and your Saviour, and you don't know him the same way you know your brother, your sister, your mother and your father, because he's real and because he's alive, your life, with the greatest respect in the world, has not yet started. Start your life tonight, accept Jesus in your heart tonight. God bless you.